of an harmony and balance that it should be, but an increasing inversion of it, which is what? The opposite of that. Because these entities feed off the frequency of death, because everything has a frequency of suffering, of deprivation, of fear. This is the major four-letter word that controls the world. It means that they're to take over our reality, they have to generate maximum amounts of that energy. So they have structured society through these bloodlines that end up in the positions of power to create maximum amounts of that energy. So look through known human history. Endless wars, endless suffering, endless deprivation, hunger, destruction, getting more and more all the time. And what they're doing is imposing their world, their inverted world, upon us. And the more they do so, the more power they have to influence this world, because we're getting closer in frequency to where they are. And so when you look at the word live, what is the word live inverted, written backwards? Evil. What we call evil is just an inversion of the natural order of life, of joy, of love. And the idea is that they eventually so transform our energetic frequency state that our world literally becomes theirs, and they won't even need their bloodlines then. What we need.
So you're saying it's like an avatar. They've got humans that operate as their Earth suits. They want to change the atmosphere, like terraforming us, to then take over completely.
Yeah, I mean, there are certain movies. In fact, more and more movies, Alex, that actually mirror this and what's happening now. Classically, what I'm describing in terms of this fake reality that we decode and believe, therefore, to be real, is the Matrix. The world depicted by the Matrix trilogy is absolutely the one that we live in its theme. And then you rightly talk about the Avatar movie, which again was mirroring reality. What happened there? You had the Navi society, the Blue People society, that was taken over by people that looked outwardly as if they were the Navi, the Blue People, but actually within that form, that outer form, was the force in the Avatar movie that was taking over that reality. And that's what we're experiencing. And this is why I say, with as much a passion as I could muster to the alternative media, you know, what's been done so far in uncovering the five-sense level of this is brilliant, fantastic, round of applause, you know, punch the air, let's have a cheer. But if we're going to understand how we're manipulated ultimately, and therefore create an understanding of how not to be in deep in the rabbit hole, we've got to start opening minds to the fact that what's happening with the banking system and ISIS and engineered wars and engineered banking crashes and engineered political systems is the play out, the projection, which is there to manipulate our society within the holographic world that we experience, but actually where it's coming from is beyond human sight. And this is very difficult for people to grasp, because from cradle to grave, all this stuff is ridiculed and dismissed as crazy. Now, let me ask this question. If this stuff is so crazy, why do these people, in their satanic rituals and their secret society rituals, the deep, extreme ones, why do they interact with another force beyond human sight? They're interacting with what? What Christians call demons, what Islamic world calls jinn. They are interacting with these entities. That's why they do it. And in terms of possession, everything is a frequency. Thus, what your type of genetics is dictating the frequency of your body, your biological computer. Therefore, those hybrid bloodlines that have a far, far greater infusion of this archon, if you like, demonic, whatever you want to call it, genetics in the hybrid, that means that their frequency is much closer to that of these entities. Thus, they become possessible on a scale that even the massive humans are not possessible in that frequency sense.
So you're saying they're basically drivable. They have the software to interface.
Exactly. What these bloodlines are, Alex, is basically a particular type of biological computer which allows these entities which have no empathy, which feed off death, which glory in death, which love death, for which death is their reality, they are vehicles for these entities to manipulate our world. So when you look at these bloodlines and how they can create mass murder in what we call wars, how they can do the unbelievable things they do that create the shocking, unspeakable terror, horror, and suffering that they do, and people kind of have dismissed that. You'll have come across this. Oh, no, they'd never do that. No, you would never do that because you have the ability to empathize. You have the ability to take an understanding of the feelings and the suffering that your actions are making other people suffer. Once you are of a genetic type and of a consciousness, this demonic consciousness, you have none of those fail-safe mechanisms of behavior. Not only do you not have empathy with the suffering you cause, you love it because you feed off it. And so these people are not seeing the world the way we see it. Look at bankers and the way they make people suffer all over the world by their manipulation of finance. They feed off that. And there's a word for it. Ask anybody, go to the dictionary, look up this word, or go on the internet and look for a definition of this word, and you will find that the definition of it is exactly the personality type that I have just described, the word psychopath. Why do we have psychopaths running the world in all these areas, all these institutions that dictate society? Why are we having, Alex, more and more psychopaths systematically recruited into law enforcement to impose the will of the political, corporate, banking psychopaths upon the people? Because the psychopathic mentality is the mentality of these archontic demonic entities, and it's just been transferred through, for the reasons I talk about, into our reality through these particular bloodlines, which don't just operate in the elite, they operate within human society as well. Now, you've mentioned pedophilia, because all these dots connect. All these dots connect, because if they didn't, then it couldn't be true, because everything connects in the end. What these entities want to feed off, almost more than anything else, is the energy of children before puberty. We see the point of puberty as a hormonal change. Yes, within the hologram, where people see the body in terms of its physical functions and hormone functions, it is a hormonal change. But the hormonal change is merely a holographic expression of an energetic change in the base field. And thus, what they want is the energy of children before that puberty energetic change happens.
And let me briefly stop you for a moment. Whether or not this is demonic, spiritual, or whatever, for anybody out there, it's a fact that every civilization ends up falling to secret society cults that demand burning or chopping or eating or cutting the hearts out of children. Every culture ends up being run by people that build temples, generally pyramids, and then want to do this to children, whether it was in Europe, whether it was in the Middle East, whether it was in Africa, whether it was in Mesoamerica. Every culture ends up going to human sacrifice, and the children are what are coveted. So what is that? What is happening? I mean, you can't deny that. I mean, normal people would never even think of such a thing. And I have that question, A, and then B, David. I'm a very loving person. I have intense empathy. But when someone messes with my family or someone, when I think about these elites, then I have fiery rage and, you know, the propulsion to strangle them. Now, I understand that negative, violent energy is bad, and these, and, you know, that's what the dark side's into. But what would you call the energy on the other side to stand up and crush these people?
Well, you know, there's this ancient theme throughout history of cultures sacrificing young virgins to the gods. Well, the gods are these entities, and young virgins is just code for children, for the very reasons I'm talking about. And the reason, Alex, that there is such a massively greater ratio, I mean, there are so many in the general population, it's staggering, but the reason there's a far greater ratio of pedophiles in the upper echelons, did I say upper echelons of society, is because of they are possessed people, possessed entities, possessed biological computers. And while the sexual act is going on with the child, these entities are drawing off through the conduit, if you like, of the pedophile, the child's energy. And it's not just in the modern world that you see this and come across this.
They're vampires.
You look, they're vampires. They're energetic vampires. Now, that's an interesting point for this reason. What do Satanists do? They feed off blood. They drink blood. Blood is vital to them. What does blood carry? It carries the genetic code for a start, but also the blood is a expression of the energy that I'm talking about.
They like to terrorize a child first, then slit their wrist and basically bleed them out over several hours to get the maximum torture. Psychopaths talk about using somebody up, and that horrifying them gives them an energy. I mean, undoubtedly, this is going on.
Yeah, I mean, when you look at what we call acupuncture, people say, oh, they put needles in the toe to cure a headache. It's nonsense. Yeah, well, no, actually, you're just ignorant, mate. What acupuncture is doing is, through the needles and other processes, it's balancing the energy flows through what are called meridians. Now, these can be identified. These can be shown to exist. They are lines of energy going all around the body. And because they go in circuits, if you've got a block in the circuit that's in your foot, that's where the block is, it can affect the head where that circuit also goes through. And so to take the block out of the foot or the toe or whatever can remove the effect, which is the headache. Now, what these meridian lines of energy are, what the Chinese called energy qi, they are the energetic expression of the blood system, of the arteries within the hologram. And so what the Satanists in our reality are doing are drinking the energy of that person via the conduit of blood, while the entities beyond human sight, some of them within these more extreme satanic rituals, actually within sight of the Satanists in the ritual. I've talked to endless Satanists who've described this manifestation of these entities in some of these really powerful rituals. They are feeding off the energy of the person directly in an energetic form because they're taking the energy on another frequency beyond human sight. And that's what they're feeding off. And so when you have a war, when you have what this ISIS organization is doing, when you have suffering of any kind in the way that we see in this bloodletting, what is a war? It's a bloodletting frenzy. And what these entities are doing with that energy is feeding off it. If we had a world of harmony, of love, of balance, These entities would not be able to exist here because their energy source will...
Well, I've talked to a lot of veterans and a lot of from World War II on, and they say, they won't talk about it, but they say during mass death, the weirdest stuff goes on.
Yeah.
And I would imagine that's because the energy is so much stronger in those areas. And would it be if we could see like a bunch of vultures converging more of these entities in those areas?
Yeah, I mean, you know, there's so much art. There's so much. I mean, I'm not into